Dear friends, today we are going to discuss about the
defined face. What are the questions in defined face? We will see. The answers probably you can do it as a homework. You can pause the video and then answer these questions and then come back for clarifications. So we will see the in a slideshow form, right? The first question is, what is the use of VOC? You know what is VOC? Voice of customers, right? This will give project ideas. Then what is the use of VOB? VOB means voice of business. The stakeholders, what is the business goal? They will have their goal, and then your product will have a alignment. The alignment should be to this goal, right? If it is not ethical to the manufacturer of, say, for example, Taskmark. So we don't want to make Taskmark items. Like that, there may be differences. No, there should not be any differences between the objective of the project and the objective of the business. And then cost of poor quality. This again leads to the CTQ. CTQ means critical to quality. Can you identify CTQ from any of the VOC, VOB or COPK? Yes, we will. And then what is CTQ? Critical to quality. This can be X factors as well as what is the use of CTQ? This is what we want to optimize, right? The one we must get, whatever item is really critical, we should concentrate on that and try to minimize if it is costly, improve if it is a profit, right? Is CTQ an X factor or Y factor? Sometimes X factor, sometimes Y factor. Y factor is ultimately very important for us. What will you do if CTQ is an X factor? Then we will consider all the effects of impacts of various X factors. Concentrate on the one which are more critical to CTQ. ABC rule is followed for that. What will you do if CTQ is an Y factor? So we will take it as the objective. Y factor is an objective item. And we will try to control the Y factor. That's the thing. What is the use of identifying types of quality costs? So we can know where to concentrate for improving the process. Where the losses are more, we can find out. How do you generate project ideas? So from customers and business. Who are all the participants in contributing to the project ideas? As I said, customers and project business stakeholders. What decides critical to quality factors? Customers' requirements. And who decides the specifications? Customer decides the specifications. And management decides the specifications based on the customer requirements. Who decides the specification limits? The process by itself limits the control limits are specified by the process itself. So the process should be improved so that the specification limits are obtained. What decides control limits? As I said, the process. Are customers involved in project ideas? Yes. Are management involved in project ideas? Yes. Are employees involved in project ideas? Yes. Everyone is involved in project ideas. Are workers involved in project ideas? Very well. Who ultimately selects the project? The team leader, green belt holder, you. Who approves the project? A financial controller. Because who knows the pros and cons of every activity, will have to go through your plan and then see whether it is achievable or within your goals, right? And is the time and cost are correctly calculated, used? So, is product or service required to be identified to generate project ideas? Yes, if it is there, it is best. Otherwise, you'll have to identify the project or idea of product first and then go to the customers, go to the public, do a survey and generate project ideas. And then come back to the business, involve the employees, stakeholders, generate more ideas and come out with a better product, at least cost. Does Kanban model analysis come into picture for any product service earlier? Yes, But mostly if you start a new product project, corner model analysis is very, very important. Because that is the time when you can decide what are the must-be factors. The must-be factors are very important. And then what is the impact of more is better factors, and what is the impact of delight factors. The impact of delight factor means, if you improve the delight factors, will it improve? Will it have an impact on sales? Right? That is the thing. What is the impact if must-be factors are absent? You will lose sales. Right? What is the impact if more is better is absent? These are the questions you'll have to answer. What is the impact if the delight factors are absent? Nothing. If the sigma level is low or DPMO is high, then the product or process is good or bad. Find out. It's bad. The product is a success in the market. That means your defects, what you consider as a defect, is not really a defect for the customer. What is Kaizen? It's small improvements that make a wonderful change. Where can Kaizen be employed? In any workplace. What can you obtain using Kaizen? We will see. There are three factors that you can get. One is improvement in performance, cost reduction. We'll see this here. The work complexity can be reduced. The performance can be improved. The process time can be reduced using Kaizen. Two CAP companies have similar average reporting time against promised reporting time of 30 minutes. Can you decide whether they are equally good? No, you can't decide, because it depends upon the variations. One may take the reporting time, average reporting time may be 30 minutes obtained from 0 minute and 1 hour. Right? Another may be from average of 25 minutes and 35 minutes. So the one with the deviation of 25 minutes and 35 minutes will be better. So standard deviation is very important. Two CAP companies have similar average reporting time, 25 minutes against a promised reporting time of 30 minutes. Can you decide whether they equally good? No. Because you have to find out how the mean time is arrived at. Standard deviation is very important. A similar average reporting time of 40 minutes against a promised reporting time of 30 minutes. Can you decide whether they're equally good? No. 40 minutes is too high. One of the two CAP companies have an average reporting time of 40 minutes against a promised reporting time of 30 minutes. Can you decide whether it is acceptable? So we have to do an hypothesis testing. Is it by chance or by significance? One of the two companies have an average reporting time of 40 minutes against a promised reporting time of 30 minutes. At 5% significant levels, the p-value is 0.035. Lower than 0.05, rejected. One of the two CAP companies have an average reporting time of 40 minutes. At 5% significant levels, the p-value is 0.07, p-value is more. So hypothesis, null hypothesis is accepted. Right. To comment on which one is better, would you like to consider variation reporting time? Yes. To comment on which one is better, how would you measure the variation reporting time? Sample data, standard deviation. What is the probability of failure? How would you determine? You will find out probability of failure is obtained from the sample testing. Okay. What data would you need to determine the probability of failure? Sample size, number of samples, and the mean value of the samples. Consider 12,000 CAP requests processed by each company every year, and any late reporting time attracts rupees 150 per penalty. What data do you need to estimate the losses for efficiency? You need to know the significance level at which you want to find out, and what is the number of CAP requests that are default, and cost is 150 multiplied by the items, the percentage. What are the graphical plots? That is charts. That is X bar R chart, and then range R chart. Runs scored by 10 consecutive innings were recorded to have a mean of 45, variance of 9, and sample deviation of 3. What is your inference? Please do it. It is a homework. Again, I am giving this problem. The same thing, mean is same, but the standard deviation is 41. What does that mean? It's bad. What are the four most important statements required in project charter? We'll see that. What is the format for business case? Business case is the first point. And then problem statement is the next point. And then goal statement is the third point. Scope statement is the fourth point. Give an example for business case, problem statement, and goal statement, and scope statement. These have been discussed in the class, and I will discuss more in the next class. Who is an ideal project leader? A green belt holder. One who knows statistics, who can determine whether the process is, who can understand the null hypothesis, and then understand whether the out of control points are actually really significant out of control points or just chance out of control points. Because you should not waste money on which you're not supposed to waste money. Who should be considered for team members? Those who are involved, who can take measurements, who knows project details, who knows the technical details of the process involved. Which stakeholders should be named in project charter? Anyone? My opinion, I may be wrong. Please check up. What is the purpose of the term key contact in project charter? So one contact will always be better because there are so many people, team members involved. You can't ask every team member and then he will not know about the other details by the other members. Therefore, there must be one key contact who knows everything about what all members are doing. What is the result of, what is the conclusion of the work carried out by the different team members in the project. How do you decide the start date and end date for each phase in project charter? That's why you have engaged the technical people who are experts in the field. How do you find percentage completion of for each phase in project charter? Again, the technical experts will know how much is completed, how much it will take time, whether it we are going slow or we are delaying or not. Can you update project charter? Yes, you have to update project charter. Otherwise, you will not be able to grow. What terms you would use to indicate current health in project charter? It is mentioned in the project charter. Please go through. Is SIPOC a process template? Yes. Is process a part of SIPOC? Yes. Process also is involved in the process chart, which is SIPOC. What is the value stream of a process? So as the raw material goes and reaches as a final product, as and when it changes its shape, quality, value, then what are the processes that are going in? We are finding out from which supplier to which department, and then where does it come out with a change in its value? That is value stream of a process. So it goes through a number of processes and finally reaches its final value as a finished product going to the customer. Which is more important in SIPOC? Supplier names, all are important, right? You need supplier names, input items, process details, output items, customer names, output products to customers finally. This will give the entire flow through from supplier to the customer. What is the difference between SIPOC and high-level process map? High-level process map is a more broader chart, more detailed chart, I would say. What is the format for high-level process map? Each and every individual process involved in the SIPOC will be discussed in high-level process map. Give an example for high-level process map. Please note, Xerox machine process map is given, discussed by the trainer in the first day. Just go through that. What will be the outcome of step one? Generate project ideas. Different projects. What will be the outcome of step two? Select projects. So you have projects for comparison and select the best project. What will be the outcome of step three? Finalize project charter and high level process map. You will give the clear cut definition of what is the project, what is the scope of the project, and what is the problem statement, and what is the ultimate objective. And what is the plan for this? How do you find whether the project is not important to business? Survey or data? How do you find whether the project is important to business? Again, survey and then sales. The improvement in sales, you know, if there is a continuous improvement in sales, that means project is important to business. If there is no improvement in sales, then the project is not important to business. Where there is a growth, it's always important. How do you find whether the project is not aligned with the organization goals? So the product must have certain features. The organizations must be inclined to accept those features and then feel that this particular features will help the organization objectives. How do you find whether the project is aligned with the organization goals? Take, for example, a product. The product is saleable and the organization goal, it is aligned with organization goals. If you are making a product that is not at all saleable, then organization goal is not aligned. Right? You want a product that could be sold. How do you find whether the business can exist in the project? Yeah, business case exists in the project if there is a revenue, profit, right? Growth. Business case does not exist. If there is no such revenue, no such profit, no such growth, then there is no business case. How do you find whether the project goal is measurable? Yeah, it must have a unit. If it doesn't have a unit, it cannot be measured. It must be physical, otherwise it can't be measured. How do you find whether the project goal is not measurable? Yeah. Anything that is not physical, no? It's not measurable. How do you identify the customers? Survey. How do you identify customers' requirements? Again, survey the customers. How do you define project plan? Have an expert team and then find out the CTQs. Have the process plan and then CTQ, CPQ. Decide on that. Have a project charter. And then go as per the project charter. How do you define the key milestones? Scope statement will be there. Like for example, a particular department has got too much of expenses this year. Probably next year we'll reduce it by 10% of what was spent last year. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much. I hope this is a very fast review of the day one program. And I wish you all the best. Hope you'll all be interested in meeting with me in the next Zoom class. Thank you.